Hi everyone, the Spider-Man here. Well, as you know everyone, in these two enclosures here, I have my Egyptian predatory beetles, Anether sex maculata, and the last time I gave them a feed was on the 8th of April, which was 13 days ago, which will be 2 weeks tomorrow. I didn't realise it was that long. So I've only got my red runners and a few superworms left. I will be getting some more different live food from the British Tarantula Show next month. I'll be getting some dubia roaches, which are a lot bigger. And I'll get some more red runners because I need some males. And I'll get some nice large crickets as well. So I'm going to get a nice variation in live food next month when the expo is here. So yeah, I'll like I did before, I'll feed the this one first, take all the cork bark out, and put a red runner inside. And let's get started. So everyone, like I said, I'm going to take all the cork bark out first. And yeah, there's the beetle just there, doing perfectly fine. This one is always very, very active, always walking around. The other one's not as active as this one, so I reckon this one could be a male. I think he's being very active because he's looking for the female. So let's just take out the rest of the cork bark. Very, very active of a night time. They do keep me awake a lot. So sometimes I have to put them in my wardrobe. Because they are very, 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 very noisy. So yeah, the last part there. So yeah, as promised, let's get a red runner and let's see if it's hungry. There we go, everyone. I've picked out a couple of red runners from my tub. So let's just get the first one and let's give it a feed. Oh, there we go. As I said before, I didn't realise it'd been a couple of weeks since last time I fed him, I should say. I thought it was a lot. Didn't know it was that long. So you can see it's attacking its prey now. It's just nicely chewing its head off. So let's just get a little bit of a closer look for you guys. There we go, everyone. It's a bit better. Let's just turn the brightness up a little bit. So they don't mess about with their food. They're straight in there, and I suppose after 13 days of not eating, I bet they're absolutely starving. So yeah, it looks like that one's eating its meal perfectly fine. Sorry, the camera's a bit shaky. That's a bit better. So yeah, I'll let this one eat its meal. And let's go on to the next one. So everyone, same with the other one. I'm going to take all the cork bark out and give it a red runner. Just get the red runner and put it in. Let's see the beetle take down its meal. Oh, little bit of attack there, guys. It didn't really seem that interested. No, it doesn't really seem that bothered, I'm afraid. I thought after nearly 2 weeks I'm not eating. Oh, here we go. Having a good fight with it, everyone. There we go. Oh, a little bit surprised they weren't going to eat. Oops.
I will give him some bigger prey items next month. Another thing I wanted to say, I want to say a massive thank you for the people that have donated to save my centipede. So yeah, the donations have been going really, really well. Still not there yet, but I should be okay this month. It's just the end of May. It's going to be a little bit of a problem, but hopefully more donations will be coming in, hopefully. So yeah, there we go, look. No messing about with these beetles. They're straight in there, eating their meal. And let's see how the other one's getting up. And there's the other one, everyone. Hasn't really got much left of its meal. It's nearly all eaten already. So like I said before, they must have been absolutely starving. I just didn't realise it'd been that long since the last time they had their meal. And you can see the mandibles hard at work now. Like I said before in the last feeding video, they're not very big. They're only around about the inch mark. Very, very small. But hopefully at the tarantula show, I'll be getting some more beetles. I'm looking for the African predatory beetle, which is a lot bigger than these. They're about 2.5 inches. They're absolutely huge. So I'll be after hopefully a couple of them. That'll be the first thing on my mind when I get there. And please stay tuned. I will be doing a video of the British Tarantula Show next month, like I did last year. So there's not much of that roach left. It was only a small roach, it weren't huge. I haven't got many big red runners left until next month. So yeah, I'll leave that one alone to enjoy its meal. And let's just quickly see how the other one's getting on. And as you can see, everyone, there isn't really much left of this roach either. So like I said, I'll get some dubia roaches from the British Tarantula Show, and they're absolutely massive, so that'll be interesting to see one of these beetles take one of them down. Let's just do a picture for my thumbnail. So yeah, like I said, not much left there, guys. So what I'll do now, I'll put the cork bark back in the other enclosure. So everyone, let's just put the cork bark back in. I like to put some cork bark underneath and lift it up a little bit so they can go underneath the cork bark. There we go, and you can see there's not much of that roach left now. So let's just put the rest of it in. We'll put the water dish in and get my syringe and fill the water dish up. So everyone, let's just fill up the water dish. There we go, and all the cork bark's back in the enclosure. There's the other one, everyone. Same again, ain't got really much of that meal left. It's eating it fairly quickly. So while I'm here, everyone, let's put all the cork bark back in so it can have a drink after its meal. So yeah, there you go. Two beetles fed perfectly fine. And thanks for watching, everyone.